Okay, so it's time to use some of that programming that you've been learning to do something completely different. We're going to take a break from CS50 for a moment, and we're going to play with 3D printing. Pretty cool, I know. So what we're going to do is we're going to incorporate both programming and 3D printing. So what I want you guys to do while I'm away here, so I want you to go to openscad.org. It's openscad.org. All right. And what I want you to do is download OpenSCAD. So you go to downloads, you'll download the appropriate thing. And if you're on a Mac, it's going to download this DMG file. You're going to open that. It'll decompress and you'll end up on a folder like this. Not so bad, right? Now what you're going to do is you're going to go to your Finder window and you're going to find Applications. And then you're going to drag this over to your applications and drop it. Now, I've already done it, so I'm not going to do it on here, but you're going to drag it in there and it'll copy into your applications. Now, the first time you run it, Mac's got a thing in there to make sure that you're, meeting the security requirements. So this should work for you. I'm not 100% sure how those Macs are set up that you're working on, but you're going to go to the file in your applications. You're going to hold the Option key down on your keyboard, and you're going to right-click, and then you're going to say Open. And then it'll give you something like, "Are you sure you want me to do it?" And then you're going to say, "Yes, go ahead and open it." All right? If that doesn't work, we'll sort it out when I get back. But what OpenSCAD does is OpenSCAD creates objects using programs. So you write a program to create a three-dimensional object. So if we go to the documentation here, you can see some of what this looks like. A little cheat sheet here, and then there's some tutorials. So work through a couple of tutorials and look for similarities in how the programming languages work. This is not C, okay? This is not C. This is different, but a lot of the same ideas are going to come into play. You're going to have variables. You're going to have for and while loops. So it's going to be similar enough that I think you can do something, all right? So what I want you guys to do today is I want you to play with OpenSCAD a little bit, and then tomorrow, when I'm back, we will talk a little bit about how we might use it to do something awesome. All right? So play with OpenSCAD, see what you can do. Even if you can't get it to run on the computers, just poke around in the documentation and the tutorials and see if you can learn a thing so that when we get back tomorrow, we'll be good to go. All right, see you tomorrow.